in the park where the Mothman meet the machines play Kill by Numbers. Down in the park with a friend called Five. Morning, ladies and gents. New shave video today. How y'all doing today? Hopefully you're doing pretty good, because I'm doing pretty good too. And tomorrow is Halloween, so we're doing a whole Halloween thing. And we're even rocking the blue sewing today. Boom. Like Doug Smythe said. Got a lot in this one, so it might be a little long, so. But just bear with me. Yeah. So that song in the beginning, I thought that'd be pretty dark for Halloween. Pretty dark lyrics, if you know that Gary Numan song, and Marilyn Manson covered it, and also the Foo Fighters covered it too. I like the Marilyn Manson one though, because the guitars are heavy, but the lyrics, ooh, go Google those lyrics, or if you know that song, pretty dark. Anyways, Halloween theme shave. So we're gonna start with brush we're gonna be using today, because I gotta have silk. Rich Man Shaving Group, Blood Oath. That's fitting for Halloween, right? F2 Innovator 26mm. Not so. Gotta get that silk in first. Then we'll talk about the rest. I did have hot water. Man. Alright, come on. Time is money. Okay, here we go. There, that might be enough. Get in this. Okay. Yeah, that'd be good. We'll let that soak. Razor we're going to be using today. You probably have already seen it already, because a lot of people reviewed it, and I think a lot of people already bought it. But it's Phoenix Artist and Accoutrements, El Fantasma. Woo! That's the razor we're going to be using today. Now, it's actually a homage to the vintage 1930s Fasson double slant razor. And this one's made out of ABS. This one's not made out of a Bakelite like the other ones. I actually have one of the 1930s Fassons, and I found out about this from Douglas Smythe's first Bakelite razors based on the Fasson twist. This one's different though. It's more slanted. I wouldn't know about Fasson razors if it wasn't for Douglas Smythe. So we're going to do a side-by-side shave with both of these today and compare them. Now, I don't know about anybody else's, but mine are actually interchangeable. I could take this top cap, put it here, and take this bottom plate and put it on. It looks kind of cool. And yes, this does glow in the dark. You've seen the beginning, right? We're not going to make it glow in the dark. That is what sparked me, though, when I first seen it. I'm like, wow, it glows in the dark. That's kind of cool razor. Then I read on it. I'm like, it's based on the Fasson. I'm getting that when I drop. So, but I want to do a side-by-side. I've never done a side-by-side shave before. So this side we're going to be shaving here, and this side we're going to be shaving here, just to do a comparison. Something I've never done. Blades we're going to be using today is Big Chrome Platinums. Now, I got about 5 days worth of growth, so we'll put it to a test. All right. Maybe I should have already had these loaded up, but oh well. Told you it might be a long video. But hey, it's a 30-minute Halloween special, right? Blade? Definitely hold it up in there. It's good. How you guys doing for Halloween? I don't know if anybody's going anywhere or trick-or-treating or nothing this year, but Halloween and Christmas, my two favorite holidays. Get the Fasson loaded up in there. Load up on a big bag of Bix. So that's in there. Got that one in there. That's the Fasson. Now, we're gonna do this big. I gotta have Gary Numan songs in my head. Here in my car, I feel safe as can be. I can lock all my doors. I can do anything in cars, you know. Was made of brass too. And I'm a little shaky. Oh yeah, I was thinking to I can't speak. Huh, too early. That's loaded up. Like the what IMCDB Chris would say, our shaverage for today, we're just drinking some Mountain Dew. No alcohol, but wake me up and get me going. That's our shaverage. So yeah, I'm gonna do a side by side. I've never done that before. Soap we're gonna be using today. It's a secret. I don't know how long it's gonna be around either, but CK6 formula, monster mashup artesian shave soap. He did the mash. He did the monster mash. This is a mashup of clown fruit and monstroso. Clown fruit's only going to be available until tomorrow. After tomorrow, after Halloween, clown fruit's gone until next year. If you're gonna want to get it, jump on it, because you won't be able to get it for another year, 365 days. This and on Monstroso, I'm not sure if it's going to be gone at Halloween or a little bit longer. Don't know. Not, I don't know. I can't. Don't quote me on that. This smells good. Off the puck, I get hit with the Haitian vetiver first. And a little bit of the clown fruit in the background, a little bit. It might bloom open more and more when I mix it up. I just woke up. But it smells good. It's blended nice. With Monstroso, the vetiver really hits you. It's real strong. But this is like blended. It's blended very good. So that's what we're using today. So, pretty sure we're going to be using something I don't think is available anymore either. Phoenix Arts and Accoutrements Glow Cube. This thing glows in the dark. We're not going to show. You've seen my past videos. You know it glows in the dark. All right. Let's go in. Let's get this going with the blue sewing. Not Sam Hain. Somebody, if you know, someone's like, oh, Sam Hain. You know they have no idea what they're talking about. Blue sewing. Like, so when? Get this in here. Glow cube. I wonder if anybody's gonna try to shave in the dark with the glow cube and the Phantasma. Do not try this at home, kids. Okay. Here we go. You wanna know how I got these scars? This human decided to carve me out of pumpkin. All right. Set that aside. Let's get this loaded up. Now this is CK6 formula, so guess what, Chris? That means you're gonna need some water, dude. That brush got some water in it. Just squeeze that for a second. Now this rich man brush is a lather monster. It's amazing. Like, it makes a lather, like, boom. So, let's see. Let's see if I use enough water. Ooh. There's the clown fruit. Wow, it's sweet. Yeah, that smells good. Wow, it's like a sweet smell. Ooh. Ooh, different. It's like clown fruit. It is. It's clown fruit and Monstroso mixed, but it creates a totally different scent from both of those. You can smell the clown fruit and the Monstroso, but it's a different, totally different kind of scent. It's real sweet. Okay. Ooh, I think I need more soap. Yeah, get a little bit more soap in there. And more water, Chris. Yeah. Told you it might be a long video, guys. But hey, the last time I did a long video. Get water in there. Wow. It creates a totally different scent. Yeah, that's nice. If I just know how to lather. Need a bit more water. There we go. Man, I'm not exaggerating. It's a sweet smell. It's cool. Yeah, telemarketers calling. I think we're good. So, I don't answer that phone. Ooh. Yeah, flinging soap. CK6 make you feel good. I think I probably said it wrong, but it's the, on the Phoenix Arts and Accoutrement Facebook page, the, not profile picture, but the other, but the bigger one, I don't know what it's called. Lady's like, okay, yeah, look at that. Lather monster. pretty fitting. Okay.
Gonna do a side by side.
Because I know how that Fasan shaves, so. Okay, here's the Phantasma. Es un fantasma, güey. Dame un fantasma, güey. Solamente 26 dólares. Pretty good, because this thing goes for $80 up to, I've seen these go up to almost $200 or $300. I paid $80 for this one. Yeah, $26. We'll see how it goes. Pass number one with the Phantasma on the right side. Okay. I said 5 days worth of growth. Wow, that's nice. Never done a side by side. It's gonna be pretty different. Get it even. Te gusta el fantasma way? I know a little Spanish. A little bit. Solamente poquito.
No mucho.
No mucho. No mames, wey. Dead ass is buey. What does that mean? Problem area, I gotta be careful. Man, that smells good. Shaving's been pretty good so far. I wouldn't say it's mild, but I wouldn't say it's medium. It's like right in between to me. Watch me chop myself up real good. Okay. I think that's good. Yeah, we'll do the stash later, but not a bad pass one. Pretty nice. So, pass one with 1930s Fasan. I know how this one shaves, so. Like I said, very expensive, very hard to find. Okay, get some of that soap up there. On a rope. Oh, already got me. I did read too. You can actually adjust it a little bit. There's the Phantasma. You can adjust it to make it a more aggressive shave. I'm not gonna do that. But you can. If it's too mild to you, you have that option to do that. And we'll get the rest with the Phantasma. Yeah, I nicked myself with that Fasan. Huh. Never done a side-by-side comparison before. My first time.
So far, this Phantasma is nice, though. Not expensive, either. $26 for something that's based off something vintage that is a good shaver. This is, I like this a lot. This is a good razor. This is pretty good so far, too, so I'm digging it. I'm digging it. Oh, got me there. Yeah, so. Yeah, very nice. Very, very nice. Except for if I learn how to shave, I might be all right.
All right, we're going to do two pass on the cheeks. We're not going to do a third pass, though. Because I don't want to.
Okay. There we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Rockin' on. Rockin' on. Here we go. Here we go. Remember those old commercials? I think that was Army. Oh, that smells so good. It's sweet. Clown fruit and monstroso, but mixed very, very nice. Very, very nice mix. If you're a fan of both those scents, you'd like that. Phantasma? I think you would. Okay, we'll do a third pass this way. I did get me here. Hey, I nicked myself with both razors. Oh yeah, very nice. Very nice. Borat. Very nice. What's on? All right. Yeah, very good, very good. And both equally nicked me, but that's my problem area. I get myself there all the time. But yeah, very nice. Like I said, if you don't want to try and find one of those vintage razors, but very sought after, try one of these. They shave pretty similarly good to me. To me, but don't quote me on it. Just my own personal take. So, all right, let's do the stash. Gonna be difficult. Hey, it's Halloween. Well, tomorrow. Okay, how are we gonna do this? Okay, Phantasma. Okay. Yeah. Good. Nice. All right. Go with the Fasson. Has a little bit more feedback on the Fasson. Doesn't mean it shaves worse or better, though, but it just has a little bit, the Fasson has a little bit more feedback to me. Look at that middle. Very good, though. Very good. Yeah.
See.
Yeah, very good. Okay. Clean up and I'll be right back. I'll be right back! What are the four words you never say in a horror movie? I'll be right back because you'll never be right back. Anyways, yeah, I'm back. Very, very nice. That's my problem area. I nick myself with any razor. Doesn't matter. Couple weepers. But yeah. Very good. Like, pretty dang close. Like, yeah, it feels like to me, the same razor almost. Like, I could feel, it feels pretty similar, so. Yeah, very good. Very good. I'm going to use a dipstick stick a little bit. Just here, because it's bleeding. I'm bleeding! And here. I think I seen one up in here. But, yeah. Whatevs! Okay. That's it for a sick Allen block. Here we go. No sting. No zing. Igor Frodrick. That's it. Now, what we're going to be finishing it off with is Phoenix Artist and Accoutrement Monstroso Star Jelly. I have the splash too, and I think I'm the only one who actually reviewed this last year on YouTube. That's kind of crazy to me. I thought more people would have jumped on that. The so-called Collective Shavers 1919. But yeah, anyway. Oh well. It smells good. Like, it's a Haitian vetiver and Moral Blood Orange. And yeah, that vetiver's, like I said, the Monstroso is pretty strong vetiver scent, and Clown Fruit is more sweet, but that blended together smells good. It's like the best of, like, it's not too vetivery, but it's not too sweet. It's like, it's good. It's good. I would suggest trying getting it. If you like both those scents, you'd like that. My personal opinion. That's it. The shaver of the day. Happy Halloween. Happy Halloween. Happy Halloween. Silver Shamrock. My opinion, one of the worst movies in the Halloween thing. Not a big fan of Halloween 3. And all the Easter eggs in it and stuff, but whatever. Bam. Oh, yeah. That was a good shave. Good side-by-side. I've never done something like that before. So, recap of what we used today. We used Bic Chrome Platinum, first use, in both razors. We also used Phoenix Artisan Accoutrements Monstroso Star Jelly. We used Rich Man Shaving. Blood Oath, the razor blade in there. 26mm F2 Innovator knot brush. Yeah, this thing's awesome. We also use PAA Monster Mashup Artesian Shave Soap, Clown Fruit, and Monstroso in one, but it's a secret, don't tell anybody. We also used El Fantasma Razor and Fasan. We also used Phoenix Stars and Couch Mint Glow Cube for the pre-shave. Now, me personally. Oh, we also used the Allen Block. Very good. Would I suggest you get one? I would. I jumped on when I seen the ads and I saw everyone else already like reviewing it and stuff. I'm like, when's it coming out? I want it. Give me that. Let me do it. If you're looking for one of these Fasan razors, this is my own personal opinion. I'm not saying facts. It's from my personal take on this razor. If you're looking for one of these, what's it called? Fasan double slant razors, and you don't want to spend that much money or even actually try and find one, this is a pretty damn good homage to this razor. I think it's pretty, almost spot on. This one has a little bit more feedback, but they've shaved pretty close to me. I think, my personal opinion, they've shaved pretty damn similar. So, if you're looking for one of these, but you don't want to spend the money on that, and you might not like it, $26, glows in the dark, yeah, it's kind of a novelty. Well, you can't see. But, you know, the whole glow in the dark thing set aside, you're looking for an old-school Fasan razor? Yeah. Very good interpretation. And it's ABS, too, so it's a lot stronger than the Bakelite. Bakelite, you could drop it and chip a tooth off or something. But, yeah. Yeah, I suggest. If you like I said, you like the Fasan, or you're looking for one, grab one of these. My personal opinion, so. That's it, ladies and gents. Oh, yeah. Our shaverage. I told you it might be a long video. It's Halloween, though. One of my favorite holidays. Of course, I'm going to talk a little bit. That was a good shave, yeah. Man. Yeah. Hope you ladies and gents have a good day. Have a good week. And be safe tomorrow out there on Halloween. And I don't know if people are going to go be out trick-or-treating because of the whole COVID thing. But just be safe anyway. And yeah. Happy Halloween, ladies and gents. I'll see y'all very soon. Bye. Bye.